Dr. Kessler? Front desk. Yes, ma'am. Well, we'll certainly check it out. Yes, right away.
From the file?
Miss Wales in 413. She claims that there's some animal noises coming from the room next door. She thinks it might be a dog. She says it's keeping her awake.
Are you going to check it out?
Well, that's Dr. Kessler's room. You know how he feels about people going to his room when he's not in there. The man hasn't had clean hands.
Well, he's a weirdo, Lyle, and a troublemaker. And if he is keeping an animal, he'll be out on the street before morning.
You'd like to come over for a beer or something. I thought maybe you'd be home, but I... I'll be up for a while, so if you get home before, you know, too late, just give me a call, okay? And, Richard, come on up.
Voice. Can you feel a beer or
something? Yeah, I love a cold beer. Why don't you just go sit in there and I'll go get it for you?
Much of madness, more of sin? Tortured and ridiculed by the scientific establishment for his investigations into the creation of superior life forms.
Noted zoologist Dr. Erlen Kessler continues his experiments in the cloaked secrecy of his basement's laboratory. Finally, after years of failure and frustration, he manages to successfully mate his own seed with an egg excised
from the ovaries of a jackal and plants it in the womb of an unwitting human surrogate, a little light reading honey. Scared yourself again and lured me over with a cold beer so you wouldn't have to be alone.
Crap.
Honey, how can you read this crap?
I don't know. It's so many things. Like potato chips. I can't stop.
Potato chips?
I don't know. This one was different, though. It was really special. I love it.
I'll bet. So, what happens? The book. How does it end?
The surrogate dies in delivery. Dr. Kessler has to raise the creature as his own son, but it's an evil. It's a wild. He can't control it.
I know the feeling.
So, one night, somebody lets the jackal boy escape. And Dr. Kessler goes out. Bringing this world returns. It leaps.
don't see what the problem is. It's not like he asked you to marry him or anything.
Yeah, well...
Excuse me.
We've only been seeing each other for 6 weeks. He already wants me to meet his parents. Over Christmas, Crimson Falls, Ohio. I don't know. Sounds like a pre-proposal to me.
Pre-proposal?
Excuse me. I think I'll take these.
Well, all I know is if I had a guy like Richard on the line, I'd reel him in.
Hmm. Yeah, like I can see you in a moo-moo and curlers. Scrambling up eggs for your husband?
Hey, you don't know us, girl, but deep down underneath all this chic cosmopolitan savvy beats the heart of a submissive house brow.
Well, Richard's really special, but I think I'll just take it slow.
All I'm saying is if I had Mr. Wright, I'd be home packing my bags for Crimson Falls.
Well, you're sure not going to meet him putting in 14 hours a day at this dump.
Well, maybe not, but the way I figure it, I'm more likely to run into a gorgeous guy in a bookstore than a smart guy in a single bar.
Hi, Mona. Hi.
Well, then again, I could just kill myself.
What the hell are you looking for?
I'm looking for this book called I, Madman. I've been looking for it everywhere, but I can't find it. It's by this guy. His name is Malcolm Brand.
Oh, that's charming.
No, don't knock it. It's really good. It's horrific. It makes Stephen King read like Mother Goose, but it's passionate. Sort of like Poe.
I never heard of him.
No, I hadn't either until yesterday. He wrote two of them. This one and one called I, Madman, which came in with the estate sale.
Well, where are you going?
Upstairs to have another look.
You sure are spending a lot of time trying to find something called I'm Madman. Somebody bought it.
Yeah, maybe.
His mouth is stopped. Honest Iago has ta'en over the fort.
He is dead, my lord.
All his hair's been lies, my great revenge and stomach for them all.
Alas, he's betrayed, and I am done.
Stop it. Who's out for him to my face?
Oh, banish me, my lord, but kill me not.
Sorry I'm late.
Oh, well, you didn't miss much.
Yeah, I can see that. Did he call us?
No.
None, there is no force.
But last I say one word.
It is too late.
I know about 20 people who'd like to do that.
Oh, my God, all right.
Any comments?
No,
great. Michael? Very good work. Incidentally, our own Miss Berkowitz is going to star in a new made for television movie, No More Yesterdays. Congratulations.
You should have gotten that part. You're absolutely perfect for it.
Oh, come on, Mom.
No, really. Perfect.
No. Colette's really talented, very beautiful.
So are you.
I hate her.
Hey. How about dinner? We'll talk about her behind her back.
No, I can't. I have plans.
Getting serious, huh?
Maybe.
Okay, we'll take one more couple. Kelly and Martin, please.
Hi. Look at this. We're not going to get it through our serum. How about a new nose and everything?
Something came up here. I pulled a narcotic stakeout, so I'm gonna have to pass on dinner. I'll try and stop by afterwards, but if it's late, well, I'll call. I miss you, and I love you, honey. Goodbye.
Oh, Mona.
Fixed it.
What do you mean?
Look, a clean slate. Fresh talent.
What are you doing?
I was just making a fire, and I heard a noise.
Yeah, I knocked. Honey, you've got to keep your front door locked. Something on the stove?
Oh, yeah. I was making some tea.
going to be away there for a while.
I'm sorry, How much do you love me, Richard?
On a scale of 1 to 10? 20.
Enough to cut off your ear?
No. Yes, I don't know. What kind of an idiotic question is that?
It's just this book I'm reading. This guy. He's a poet. He's a doctor, really, but he sort of dropped out. Anyway, he's madly in love with this actress named Anna Templer. But she won't have anything to do with him because she thinks he's really ugly. She just can't get past it.
So, he cuts off his ear.
It's totally hopeless. He's desperate to please her. Then one night, he's been drinking heavily. And you'd have to be more than just insane to have these thoughts. He goes into his closet, digging around for his old medical bag. He finds it and takes it out, over to a mirror. He pumps his face full of Novocaine, and then with his scalpel begins to slice away his features one by one. And he's crazed with love.
Oh, so he slices off his face. Oh, great, the guy's never heard of a candygram or flowers?
Only a book, Richard.
Yeah, well, it gives me the creeps.
Okay, we won't talk about it anymore.
You know, you always get weird when you read that shit. But, if it'll make you feel any better, first thing after breakfast, I'll cut myself shave.
Stood in the shadow of an island, watching and waiting. Watching and waiting for that special one. It had to be a woman's. I knew that for sure. Only she spends the time caring and cultivating and combing. A silken crown, a downy frame around a painting as beautiful as the portrait itself. They were all out. The jet blacks. The mousy browns. The bleached blondes. And I was right. Until Red came along. Perfection. Soft as cloud and brilliant as sun, a flaming crimson torch of feathers, ready and ripe for easy picking. Thank you.
Slowly from 100.
1st edition Hemingway. Well, old lady Vady came in yesterday after you left. She had a shit fit when she saw that stuff hasn't been unpacked yet. Oh, you know, that stuff upstairs, the estate sale shipment.
Oh, yeah.
I'll clean this up.
Okay, I'll unpack.
Yuck. Who'd want to buy a used sex manual?
Mona, where did you find this book?
What are you talking about?
Well, didn't you leave this outside my door last night?
Well, this is the book you're looking for, right?
Uh-huh.
Well, I didn't find it.
Before, I'm a friend of Richard's. Is he back yet?
No, but I gave him your message to about half hour ago.
I know, but it's very important that he calls me back.
Well, all I can do is give it to him again. I'm sure he'll call you back.
Yes, thank you.
Okay.
But have him call me back as soon as possible.
Okay.
The music.
Why are you doing this to me?
Lovely.
Please, leave me alone.
You'll come around. You will love me.
Oh, I don't love you. I'll never love you.
Thank you.
this way.
Right. Yo, any news about the witness? Not a word. Check this out. Hello, gentlemen.
Yeah, bag those up.
We got anything?
Well, not much. Male, probably 6'2 or 6'3. Didn't leave any fingerprints.
Look at this. Son of a bitch sliced his ears off.
Excuse me. I believe that shade was down.
Killed the Berkowitz woman? How do you know that?
Because he showed me this morning on the bus.
Virginia, we're not following you here. Why don't we just take it from the top, okay?
It all started with the book.
A book?
Richard knows about it. It's this weird book that I picked up where I work. Somehow this character got out.
He got out.
He got out of the book. It's like, one minute I was reading about him, and the next minute he was standing right next to me. He thinks that I'm his actress named Anna Templer, and she's in the book, too.
Mm-hmm. And he doesn't have a nose.
No, he doesn't have anything. He cut it all off. His hair, his ears, his lips, and his nose, everything. And now he's going to go around and take things from other people so he can, like, graft them onto his own face.
Miss Clayton, why would he? Why would anybody do such a thing?
Because he thinks that it will please me. He thinks it will please Anna. But because he thinks I'm Anna, it's really the same thing, right?
Well, I want to thank you very much for coming in.
Oh, look, I mean, I know this must sound really crazy.
No, really. You've been a big help. Really. Detective, when you have a moment, my office, please.
Can you give me a minute here, please?
Yeah, sure.
What is happening to you?
I know, it sounds crazy.
You damn right it sounds crazy.
If you don't believe me, you should just read the book. It's all right there.
I don't have to read the book. It isn't real.
Sorry to interrupt. Garb is waiting, Richie.
Look, I know you had a terrible night. Why don't you wait downstairs for me, and when I finish with the lieutenant, we'll go home and we'll try and figure out just what you think you saw. Please, just wait for me downstairs.
Doubleday. What can I do for you?
Well, actually, sir, if you don't mind, I have something I'd like to show you.
I only publish month.
No,
I... Look, honey, I would love to chat with you, but I got a lot of work to do here.
Did you publish this book?
So my moniker's all over it. So what is it to you?
I want to know about Malcolm Brand.
Look, I wasn't married to the guy. I just published a couple of his books.
Please.
You doing a paper or something? College? I don't know what to tell you. The books speak for themselves. The guy was a lunatic. Spent the last year of his life in a rubber room. And that's where he wrote the last one. One day he just took a powder, walked right out through the gate. Nobody paid any attention. Found him nearly a week later. Said it was exposure, but they couldn't be sure.
Why not?
Because by the time they got to him, his body was ripped apart by some animals. Probably a pack of hungry dogs. He was a weirdo, all right. I remember once right after his first book.
Much of Madness, More of Sin?
Yeah, that's the one. Did pretty well, and even had a bit of a following. Anyway, I got an assignment. A short story. Esquire, kiddo. And we're talking about the mainstream, and they wanted them. So Malcolm started working on her right away. 2 months later, he returns the advance money and tells me he can't finish the story. And get this, claims the characters were talking back to him, refusing to do what he says. One even chased him out of town for a couple of weeks. The monster from the first book, you know, the jackal boy, claims it hated him, was hunting him down. Some return of evil for evil.
You published this book as nonfiction.
Both books were nonfiction. Malcolm insisted, claimed they were confessions. He was a ranting schizophrenic. Of course, nobody believed anything he said.
So the stuff in the book, about what he did to himself.
Oh, geez, yeah. He messed himself up pretty bad, all right.
Yeah. Okay. You got the coroner on three and your girlfriend's on one.
All right, just call me if you find anything else. Dr. Price, could you hold on for just 1 minute? Yeah, I appreciate it. Thank you. Virginia?
Why didn't you wait for me downstairs? Where the hell are you?
Listen, Richard, you're never going to believe this. I know where he's going.
What are you talking about?
There's going to be another killing tonight. Another guy. A Mediterranean type, olive skin with a strong Roman profile. Brent could have fallen home from a bar jack to Cameron Grant.
Virginia, I can't talk about this now. The phones are ringing off the hook. I've got two murders to solve.
Damn it, Richard. Listen to me. I'm telling you, it's Brand, and he's back to finish what he started, what he wrote about doing in the book.
And I'm telling you that I don't believe in ghosts. Look, just hold on a minute, all right? Dr. Price, thanks for... Oh, shit. Virginia?
Little girl?
Christ.
Hey, I'm sorry. So what's going on? Waiting for someone?
No. Well, yes, actually, I was waiting for an old friend.
Something about Colette, huh?
It's a terrible thing.
It's horrible.
You know, I was thinking of picking up a pizza and going home. You're welcome to join me. I mean, if your friend isn't shy.
Oh, thank you, but I think I'll just wait here for a little while longer. Thanks, anyway.
Okay, sure. Well, some other time, then?
Okay.
See you back in class.
Okay. See you later.
Lieutenant.
Evening. Okay, what do we got here?
Another mutilation, sir. He got the nose this time.
Jesus. I understand we have a witness?
Yes, sir. She's right over there.
Oh, hell.
Sir?
Oh, nothing. Where's Channing?
He's on his way.
Come here.
I couldn't do anything. I couldn't make it stop.
Just roll your hands on the ground. I hit a button
and you just couldn't deal with it, right? You just couldn't deal with it. That there might be some truth in what I'm saying. What's the matter with you?
I'm sorry, okay? Maybe I should have looked in this thing a little bit more than I did. But Garver has running down other leads. Now he's my boss. What am I supposed to do?
He said, just bring the foot picture, please. And then we'll talk about it.
Okay, all right. I admit there are certain similarities, okay? I'll even go as far as to say that maybe there's some kind of copycat killer out there. Somebody who's read the book and is getting off on the gore. I don't know.
That's fine, Richard, but it doesn't explain Malcolm Brand showing up in my apartment.
Look, let's just try and stick close to Earth for the time being, all right? Now, what we have to do is we have to figure out when this maniac is going to strike next.
Well, it's right here. It's here in Chapter 8. I watched her before. Perched behind her desk, lonely lady librarian, rose-starred swan. Oh, how I imagined her sweet full lips burning passionately against her pillow late at night when the stone-cold cat ceased standing guard over her lust. He means the library. I mean, it's all right here, right down to the stone-cold cat. He means the lions outside the steps of the main branch. Do you see?
So what happened in the end? To the girl, I mean, Anna.
You don't want to know.
Yes, I do.
He cuts out her heart with a scalpel, and he wears it around his neck. Like a crucifix. Close to his own heart. Hello?
Looks like we're in luck. Garber's gonna let us go for it. He's even thrown in some uniforms.
Oh, that's great news, Richard.
Well, it took some doing, but he's desperate. And if we're wrong...
No, we're not wrong. I'm positive about this. He'll be there tonight.
All right. The library closes at 8 o'clock. Can you be there in 1/2 hour?
In 1/2 hour. Okay, I'll be there. Mona, I'm gonna leave work a little early tonight. All right?
Fine.
Mona, is there something wrong?
No, nothing. Nothing's wrong. Just because you've walked around here like a zombie all day, you haven't said 2 words to me since you got here. Now I'm going to be stuck here doing your work while you run all over the city fighting crime or something.
Oh, it's the estate sale stuff. I forgot to unpack it.
The least you can do is let me in on what's going on.
Well, I will. I'll call you later. And that stuff, I'll unpack it tomorrow morning. Okay?
Well, forget about it. I'll finish it off tonight.
Okay, I'm gonna go. And I'll call you later. Okay. Thanks, Mom.
Yeah.
Bye.
If you see or hear anything at all, you let us know. We'll be listening on that radio.
The Rennicotts have all been briefed. Business as usual.
Could you understand that? Now, it's possible that this guy's been watching you for a few days, so we don't want you to do anything unusual. What you normally do when you lock up, that's what we want you to do tonight.
All right, kids, showtime.
There. I'm all set.
Hey, you're sure you're okay?
Yeah.
Here we go.
Everybody ready?
I
sure you want to do this?
No, not particularly, but I'm the only one who fits the suit.
That's it. Go. Show up. What can we do?
Listen, Richard, it's gonna happen tonight. I mean, maybe not here, but somewhere. It hasn't happened already. I mean, you know, there's more than one library in this city.
Not with cats on the front steps. Now, come on, Virginia. We gave it a shot. It didn't pan out. We can't stake out every building in the city with books inside based on some cryptic passage from a 30-year-old novel. Now, let's go back to my apartment, all right? And we'll talk about it later.
Okay. Right, later.
Vamonos, Richie. You got some shit to shovel.
Channing, I want to talk to you. Now.
And cats.
Mr. Channing's desk, Detective Fishman speaking. Oh, hi, Bridget. No, he's in with the lieutenant right now. Sure. Okay, I'll get it to him. Bye.
Fishman, where are you going?
An important message for Richie.
Hey, wait a minute, let me see that. Yep, Richie's nutty girlfriend. Believe me, you won't be doing him any favors by bringing this to him now.
I knew you'd come, Anna. It's our wedding day.
No!
only your heart will be mine.
home.